Here's a very interesting problem for us. It says we're going to use a graph to find a limit. Now, we're just looking for the trend in y. Find the limit of f of x as x approaches 3, where f is defined as a piecewise function. F of x, or y, is always equal to 2, provided x is not equal to 3. But if x is equal to 3, then y is equal to 0. That looks like this. Here is 1, here is a 2, and here is 3. So 1, 2, 3 on the y. And our graph will look just like this for all values except when x is 3. So here's x equals 1, here's x equals 2, and here's x equals 3. When x is 3, y goes to 0. And so it's not up here. Now, let's look at the trend in y. We can make a little chart here. When x is 1, y is 2. When x is 2, y is 2. When x is 2.5, y is 2. When x is 2.9, y is 2. When x is 3.01, y is 2. When x is 3.5, y is 2. When x is 4, y is 2. Now, if I made this chart for you, for these values of x, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2.9, 2, 3.1, 2, 3.5, 2, 4.0, 2, where would you guess what would be the trend in y as you squeeze in on x equals 3, given that that would be your little mental chart? Hopefully you would guess that the limit of this function as x approaches 3 would be 2. That's the trend in y. Notice the fact that f of 3, the function value at 3, is 0. That's this point here. The fact that f of 3 equals 0 has no bearing on the existence of the value of the limit as x approaches 3. The trend in y, as we squeeze in on this x value of 3, the trend clearly, look at the trend. If you were in Las Vegas, you would hopefully bet that right there, the y would be a value of 2. Ah, they fooled you. It went down there. But that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that the actual value fell down here. What matters, I'll say it one more time, it's the trend. The trend in y, that's the limit. The trend here is that y should be going to 2. Ah, it's down here. Does not matter. The trend remains that the limit is 2, because that's the trend in y.